Morning. How are you? So here's the deal with today. You can stand if you want. You can sit if you want. Be at the altar if you want. This entire service, okay? We're just going to worship God, and we're going to praise our God, and we're going to thank Him for just all He's done, all He is, and how faithful He is. And I want to encourage you, if you're struggling with something today, I want you to be able to worship God fully in spirit and fully in truth, okay? Let's pray together before we get started. God, we love you and we thank you for how good you are. God, and that your grace is sufficient and that your provision is always there. God, I pray as we worship you today, Lord, hearts be focused on you and minds be focused on you, Lord, and that we can fully give ourselves to you. In your name we pray. Amen. But we're going to have a party first, okay? So...
glad you're here. I'm excited about spending a morning praising and worship God. Just count this morning as heaven practice, because when you get there, that's what you're going to be doing. Keith Green said, if you're bored with worship, you're probably going to be bored in heaven. He might be right. I'd like to welcome you here this morning. This morning we're doing things a little different. Where'd he go? We lost him. Okay, broke a string. Likely story. I should give him a hard time while he's not up here, because he always gives me a hard time when I'm up here. Anyway, we're doing things a little different this morning because Dean's not speaking. I knew that would get applause, because we got to give him a hard time, okay? But we're just going to praise and worship the Lord today, and some of that's because it's Lane's last day, and that's a sad thing, but it's good to worship God, and to do that together is an awesome, awesome thing. If you are here for the first time, I encourage you to fill out a Connect card, and even if you come here all the time, there's three kinds, one for brand new people, one for people here all the time, and another one if you want to sign up to get involved in stuff, and so I encourage you to do that, or you can sign up on the Church Center app too, which is a lot easier, okay? So we're 2 weeks into the 21-day fast. There are a bunch of us doing that, and if you have any questions, need anything about that, or you just want to get in on the last week, talk to me today before you leave. I'd be happy to help make that happen. There still are bags of blessing. There are bags our middle schoolers have put together if you want to hand out to someone as homeless that you see as you're driving into Lexington or wherever. I encourage you to pick those up in the lobby and take those with you and have one or two in your car just to give away. That's awesome. Super Bowl is coming, okay? And I like watching the Super Bowl, but here's what I found. Almost everybody is looking for a party to go to, or they have one they're going to for Super Bowl. Even people that don't like football will go to a Super Bowl party. I would encourage you to use that as an opportunity to reach unsaved friends for Jesus. So I don't know if you realize it or not, but because we had a couple Super Bowl, I can rock tight. We had a couple Super Bowl parties last year, and we actually have a family or two that are here who came to a Super Bowl party and got baptized in the year since. Amen. So God works through stuff like that. God takes simple things and will use them to reach people. And I would encourage you to grab the opportunity. So, again, there's stuff out on the foyer, or you can come and see me, or you can sign up on the app for more information, and I'll send you junk, okay? Or just call me, text me. Congregational meeting is, how many weeks? Is that 2 weeks, Dean? Yes. In 2 weeks, there's a congregational meeting after church. It's our annual congregational meeting, and I have to make sure I announce that. Also, on that same day, that night, there is American Heritage Girls are hosting a date night for family and friends, and that is February the 4th, so make sure you write that on your calendar and save that. Also, this Tuesday, the youth are going to Russell Cave to do that. And last thing, so if you're interested, talk with Carl about that, Russell Cave. It's a cool thing to do. Last thing on my list, I only have 47 announcements. That's it. We're trying to cut it down to 45, okay? Sorry. But last thing is this. We have a bunch of awesome Bible classes that meet at 9 o'clock. And if you're interested in that at all, if that's something you'd like to be a part of, there are a bunch meeting. And we've added several over the last 6 months or so. So I would encourage you to do that. God has written you love letters. It would be silly not to read them. Okay? Stand and pray with me, if you would, please. You're such an awesome God. And as we just sang earlier, surely you're in this place. The Bible says you inhabit the praises of Israel. The people of your God, as we praise you today, Lord, we invite your presence to come and soak in our lives. Lord, we invite you to come and minister to us. Prick us to listen and obey. In the name of your Son, Jesus, we pray. Amen. All right, turn to your neighbor, let them know you're glad to hear, and ask them if it's cold enough for them today.
Yes. may have been bad timing, but.
Thank you.
never cry. You answer me from where the thunder hides. Can't outrun this heart I'm tethered to. With every step I collide with you.
Like a tidal wave crashing over me, rushing in to meet me here. Your love is fierce like a hurricane that I can't escape, tearing through the atmosphere. Your love is fierce. The only thing I found is through it all, you never let me down. You don't hold back, relentless in pursuit. At every turn, I come face to face with you. Like a tidal wave crashing over me, rushing in to meet me here. Your love is fierce like a hurricane that I can't escape, tearing through the atmosphere. Your love is fierce. Your love is fierce. Chase me down. Could I be lost when you have called me found?
Chase me down, seek me out. How could I be lost when you have called me found?
You chase me down, you seek me out. How could I be lost when you have called me found? Chase me out, you seek me out. How could I be lost when you have called me found? Like a tidal wave crashing over me, rushing in to meet me here. Your God.
The whole For many, many years, I'm talking about like 1990, and as my grandkids refer to that as the olden days. But when Bedford Acres was still occupying a small building at 150 Skyview Drive in Bedford Acres subdivision, we had begun to fill our sanctuary, which wasn't a great task because the sanctuary only seated about 80 people. But it became clear to us that if we were going to continue to reach out to people in this community, that we needed a bigger space. So we formed a building committee. And at our very first meeting, I can remember, kind of made an impression on me because we went around the room and tried to think of what was the most important thing in a church and what brought people into the church. And as we continued to discuss this, people talked about children's programs, youth programs, outreach. And in fact, in the 1990s, one of the things that was a great outreach was a softball team. Now, you can see that things change over the years. When we first decided to buy this property here, our first layout included a softball diamond, but we've never had to do that because one gentleman said, I'm a little bit confused because I always thought the most important thing is the doctrine of the church. And it became clear to us that that is the most important thing, is the doctrine of the church that you attend. Now, it may not be the thing that brings people in initially. You may have to do some of these outreach programs, be friendly, you know, invite your friends. But the one thing I can say about Bedford Acres, in the many, many years, you know, 35 years or so, the doctrine has been the main thing in this church. It is always focused on Jesus Christ, the teachings of the New Testament. And I've been here during that time, and I've seen senior ministers come and go. I've seen youth ministers come and go, worship leaders come and go, even elders come and go. But in all of that time, every Sunday morning, this church has never failed to focus on Jesus Christ and what he means to you and me. And there's no greater symbol of that than the time we set aside right now and be obedient to Christ and partake of the emblems which represent his broken body and his shed blood because of his love for you and me. And it gives us an opportunity, as Paul teaches us, to put everything out of our mind, whether good or bad, that affects us, and to focus on that great sacrifice, the great love that Jesus has for you and me. And it gives us an opportunity to once again be obedient to Him, protect those emblems, and know that by doing so, we have the opportunity and the hope of spending eternity in the presence of God. Would you bow with me, please? Our Heavenly Father, we just come before You now and thanking You for this church and the opportunity it gives us to participate as like believers in worshiping You, in praising You. And as we partake of these emblems, it's my prayer this morning that each of us might do so as Paul teaches, in a worthy manner, blocking out everything and just focusing on that one thing, and that's that great sacrifice. We ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. We're in prayer again. Our Father God, we return a portion of the material things that You've given to us, and it's our prayer that these will be used to further Your kingdom. They will be used to bring people into the church and bring people to face their salvation and accept You as their Lord and Savior. In Christ's name I pray. Thank you.
grace abounds in deepest waters. Your sovereign head won't be my guide. Where feet may fail and fear surrounds me, you never failed and you won't stop now. And I will call upon your name and keep my eyes above the waves. When oceans rise, my soul will rest in your embrace, for I am yours and you.
Spirit, lead me where. I'm not gonna
planted earth has quaked before. Moved by the sound of his voice, seas that are shaken and stirred can become and broken from my regard.
Thank you.
This is my prayer. Psyched you out, Bobby, didn't I? He thought I was going to start singing. This is my prayer. I hope and I pray that Bedford Acres is a church that is so on fire for God that it doesn't matter what the community thinks. It doesn't matter what individuals think. It doesn't matter what anybody other than God thinks. Now, a word of warning. If you start to live for Christ and follow Him faithfully, the enemy will come and he will attack. It is a guarantee. Why wouldn't he? This room is where you get marching orders for your walk with Christ. And alongside that, you continuously understand and read into those marching orders that you have via the Word of God. And you grow, and you read, and you pray, and you struggle, but you're faithful. God has never once forsaken us, not once. We have a tendency to forsake Him every chance we get. He's never forsaken us. If you want a revival in your home, it starts with you. It doesn't start with your wife. It doesn't start with your husband. It doesn't start with your kids. It starts with you. If you want a revival in your church, it starts with you. Dean can get up here and preach as hard as he can, but if your heart's as hard as a rock, it'll never hit. I can get up here, and these guys and gals can get up here, and we can sing every song under the sun. We can lift our hands and worship, and we can be intentional, but if you're not intentional in your heart, it means nothing. You say you want a revival. You say you want to see God move. You and I have to open up and be diligently seeking Him. That's how this works. My last day may be here today, but that doesn't mean that it stops for me or you. If anything, we continue on. Lane's just going to a different mission field. And that's okay. Does it hurt? Absolutely. Have I been very upset sometimes? Absolutely. But if I rely on myself and my own understanding and I lean on that, it's just going to fall over. So as we continue in three more songs, my prayer is this. My question is this: where are you at? Do you want to be somebody who's seeking revival in your life, in your personal walk with Christ, in your family? Dads, are you wanting to see a revival in your relationship with your spouse and your kids to where you're leading your family the way Christ has called you to? Ladies, are you asking God to revive the love that you have for your husband and your kids and help you not be so tired and exhausted from being a mom and a wife and doing all the things that moms and wives do? Kids, are you looking for something that can show you the love of a father? Because sometimes dads don't get it right. Why would we hold on to ourselves when we've done nothing but fail? If you don't know Jesus, I want to introduce you to Him. Before there was ever anything, He was. Before there were any stars, He was. Before there was any water, He was. Before there was ever sky, He was. Before you ever breathed a breath, he was. And he is. I am. I think I would trust in somebody that can say to me, I am all of it. I am before and I will be after. I want to believe and put my faith in something that is beyond space, time, and matter. Don't you? Beyond my understanding. And that same Jesus, John tells us that he took on flesh, was born of a virgin, came down. Around 30 years, he called some first disciples. They started doing ministry. And at 33, he was crucified. Why? He was the only chance we ever had. And God knew that. So again, as we sing these, if you want to accept Christ as your Savior, I want to encourage you to do that. It's the best decision you'll ever make, ever. If you need to rededicate your life, go ahead. If you need to bring your family and pray with your family, do it. Men, lead the way. Lead your families. If you need prayer for something specific, come and do it. Don't let yourself get in the way of this. Don't do it. Would you sing with me?
We've seen what you can do, O God of wonders. Power has no end. You've done before. You will do again. 'Cause there's no prison wall you can't break through, no mountain you can't move. All things are possible.
Say. just your voices. Come awaken, just your voices.
Nothing else.
So come on, my soul, don't you get shy on me and lift up your song. You've got a lion inside of those lungs. Get up and praise the Lord. So come on, my soul, don't you get shy on me and lift up your song. Get up and praise the Lord. So I throw up my hands and praise you again, so that I have is a hallelujah. And I know it's not much, God, I'm nothing else fit for a king, except for a heart singing hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I throw up
I want to leave with. And they actually had it on the screen there earlier, and I thought that was just a total God thing also. But in Numbers 6, verses 24 through 26, it says this: The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. Church, my prayer is that God just continues to just bless and grow and bless and grow and bless and grow. But I can tell you for a fact, nothing will happen if you're not willing to serve God. You can't expect anything to happen if we are stagnant. You can't. Now may the Lord of peace himself give you peace at all times. In every way, the Lord God be with you all. Amen. Well, that was all fun and games, so it was awesome, church, to be able to worship with you here for 4 years. Thank you for allowing my family to be able to be plugged in such a way that you have poured into our lives, and hopefully we've been able to do some of that for you, but above all else, my prayer is that God's gotten glory through every bit of these 4 years. You guys knew me as the weirdo on live feed that was dressing up in wigs and singing Girl Like You and Beauty and the Beast, and like that's how you met me. And you showed grace, so thank you. But we were able to come in together and to worship together. And to just pour into one another. And my prayer again is that you continue to do that. So, let's go out with a banger. It's kind of like the church anthem. You know what I mean? Like, I kind of see it like the church anthem. So, after I'm done, if you want to come up and say anything, by all means. When I'm done, if you want to come up.
Thank you.
was walking the wayside, lost on a lonely road. I was chasing the highlight, trying to satisfy my soul. All the lies I believed in left me crying like the rain. I saw lightning from heaven, and I've never been the same. Oh yeah, yeah.
I'm gonna climb a mountain, I'm gonna shout about it. I am a child of love. I found a world of freedom, I found a friend of Jesus. I am a child of love.
I felt the sting of the fire, but I saw you in the flames. Just when I thought it was over, you broke me out of the grave. Hallelujah.
I'm gonna climb a mountain, I'm gonna shout about it. I am a child of love. I found a world of freedom, child of love. Oh, oh, yeah.
Yeah. I am a child of love. Oh,
oh, yeah.
Yeah. I am a child of love.
Nothing can change the way you love me. Nothing can change.
Change the way you love me. Nothing can change the way I belong to you. Yes, I do. Nothing can separate.
I'm gonna climb a mountain. I am a child of love. I found a world of freedom.
Worship leader, we don't have to do this. 4 years ago, and a little change, we were looking and we prayed and we fasted, and the Lord sent us this guy. And I was thinking about that just a minute ago, and thinking about this verse that was going through my head, and in the Old Testament, in 2 Chronicles, chapter 20, verse 18, it says, "And Jehoshaphat," there's a funny name, "bowed his head with his face to the ground, and all Judah inhabitants of Jerusalem fell before the Lord, worshiping the Lord. And the Levites of the children of the Kohathites and of the children of the Korahites stood up to praise the Lord God of Israel with a loud voice. And they rose up early in the morning and went forth into the wilderness of Tekoa. And as they went forth, Jehoshaphat stood and said, 'Hear me, O Judah,
and ye inhabitants of Jerusalem, believe in the Lord your God, so shall ye be established. Believe his prophets, so ye shall prosper. And when he had consulted with the people, he appointed singers unto the Lord, that they should praise the beauty of his holiness. And as they went out before the army to say, praise the Lord, for his mercy endures forever. And they began to sing and to praise. And the Lord set ambushes against the children of Ammon and Moab, Mount Seir, which had come against Judah. In the Old Testament, it was very common for the people of Israel to, when they went to battle, they would put their singers first. We have been blessed for the last 4 years to have a warrior who literally came from the army, but has led us in worship. The level of worship, the attitude of worship and praise that we have now is so far than, you know, down, I think, even closer to where God. We're not there yet, no, but thank you so much, Lane. Thank you. Thank you for being a warrior for the Lord. I will tell you now, I've been praying every day that the Lord would burn down a church in North Carolina. He didn't. He doesn't always do what I want. Duh. But seriously, we do covet your prayers as we are searching. We know that this is what God wants, even though it's not necessarily what we want. His ways are higher than ours, different than ours, and we rejoice in that. But just like that church there was praying for the right person and found him in this guy, he's got the right person for us as well. And so we covet your prayers for that as well. We are going to be patient. Lane has done a tremendous job, not just in what he does, but in preparing this team to be able to continue doing a lot of that, even though he's not here. And certainly we are so grateful for that. He didn't just come to lead. He came to build leaders. And I think he has done that. He has touched every one of us in different ways. Personally, I want to thank the Lord for today. There are so many battles going on that some know about, some don't. Every one of us has got stuff going on. And this series that I'm preaching on true worship, or real worship, was actually set in place long before Lane said he was going to leave. And then when he came to me and said, hey, what do you want to do the last day? I said, what would you like to do? And he said he'd like to do this. And honestly, with some of the stuff that our church has faced in the last year and facing now, it couldn't be more perfect. Again, God's ways are perfect. And we thank you, all of you, for being submissive to God's will. One of my favorite sermons, probably for a lot of people, that Wayne Smith ever preached, and it's been around a long time. He preached it every so often, but it's called Playing Hurt. A lot of us are playing hurt because God's making Lane leave. It hurts, but God is faithful. And there's a passage in Acts, I think it's Acts chapter 20, where the Ephesian elders, they loved Paul. They loved him so much. And there's a passage where it says they were on the shore with him, and they got down on their knees, and they grabbed his ankles, and they were in tears. Because he told them that, not that he was just going to Jerusalem, that wasn't the problem. The problem was they knew they would probably never see him again. I'm glad we don't have to do that. Is it okay with you guys if he comes back sometime? Okay. Just want to make sure, and I don't want to get in trouble later for, you know, having him come back sometime. But one thing we definitely want to do, and we did this a couple weeks ago, but we want to do it again. Sarah, you're here somewhere, aren't you? Are the boys downstairs? Well, you come on up here, and Mom and Dad, come on up here. Get your Mom and Dad with you.
Get on up here, man.
Huh? I know. Oh, there's one of them. Asher, I would not have forgot you were one of my children, okay? Come on, Mom and Dad, come on up here. This is Sarah's mom. They've been here a few times over the years, but they're here helping pack. Yeah, we're not happy about that, but I'm sure it's a lot of help. We thank you for the daughter you raised, because she's done a good job raising Lane, okay? And I want to get the team around him again, and I'm going to have our elders coming up here, and we definitely want to pray for them. This isn't easy, but God is in it, and we are supposed to rejoice. And so by faith, we're going to rejoice in what he's going to do. And so, again, on behalf of the congregation, we do thank you so much for the last 4 years. Not just you, Lane, but Sarah, too. And you're all right, too, Asher. And your brothers. They're not here to hear it, but you tell them, okay? All right.
Pray with me. Father in heaven, Lord, we just lift the Goffs up to you and what it is that you've put on their heart. Father, be with them as they continue to pack and move down to their new church. Father, I just pray that the church will be as welcoming to them as we were here. Father, we just thank you for their commitment here and ultimately their commitment to you. Father, we just love you and we're so thankful that we had the opportunity to worship with Lane and his family and to praise you for being the King of Kings. Father, we just thank you for your sacrifice. Just continue to help us grow here at Bedford Acres to get closer to you. And Father, we just thank you for the opportunity again. These things we pray in Jesus' precious and holy name. Amen.
God bless you all.